Good morning. It's Saturday the 16th of December and we have very special guests with us this weekend, Brandy's sister and brother-in-law, who are on set as I demonstrate how to cook a pot roast lamb. So to cook a pot roast lamb, teeth in, start with a good pot. This is a Le Creuset. And in the bottom is some thick cut bacon that I got from the butcher. And because I don't like the packet stuff in the supermarket because it's too wet and slimy. So put your bacon in here. Then the next part is going to be to sear the lamb. So sear the lamb. I've got an 8 pound I won't call it a joint because I did in fact call it a joint at the butcher's the other day. I went in and said, I'd like a joint of lamb. And the butcher looked concerned and I said, you know, a joint of lamb. And he said, well, we've got a hippie guy who works here this afternoon. I think he could help you. And I thought, for goodness sake, a joint of lamb, a roast lamb. And then, you know, the clouds parted. Oh, I work well in England. We call it a joint. But obviously, in the west coast of Canada, joint means something else. There you go. Lost in translation. So, I have, by the way, washed my hands. So this is, vegetarians should turn off now. So, 8 pounds of boned lamb. Marvellous. You're just searing it, you're not cooking it. So, being very brave. The fire, I think the smoke alarm will probably go off in a second. Right, that's enough. So, this beautiful piece of meat is now seared. Oh. Right, now we've got the carrots. I sometimes overdo the carrots, but there's at least 4 big carrots tossed in butter, and you just push the carrots down around the side of the joint. English joint, not Canadian joint. Then, oh, this is lovely. A bit more butter. The cardiac special. Right, so, okay, sometimes I have it with carrots all over the top, but it can be a bit too much, so we're trying to demonstrates that I have found my moderation button. Jeannie says I don't have one. Right, next thing. At least a cup of nice red wine. If you use the vinegary stuff, it really doesn't work. You have to use the good stuff. If it was later in the day, I would be drinking at the same time, but sun is not yet over the yard arm, so we have to observe sun standards. Right, slosh the wine over there. Put in some thyme, this is just from my kitchen deck. And then put in a few bay leaves. And that is essentially it. What I'm going to do now is I'm going to cover it, seal it, and then later today it's going to go into the oven on 325 for 2¼ hours. So this is it so far. You will see it later. So goodbye for now. Later on the 16th, a Upon mature reflection, I have decided that because the meat is still quite exposed and it's going to be in the oven for 2.25 hours, I'm going to put some leftover bacon and secure it with some toothpicks. So this will just stop the top of the lamb burning, and also the bacon fat will seep down and help to flavour the carrots as well, so it's going to be absolutely fabulous. So I'll see you later. Bye for now. Later on the evening of the 16th of December, the lamb has now been in for 2.5 hours, and moment of truth. No smoke, that is a very good sign. I think the addition of the bacon on top probably was a good plan. Come get the cocktail forks out. Oh, and I must show you, we will fast forward to when we've actually got it plated, but I have to show you the plates. The aerated bread company plates. A gift from my godfather John Clark, who used to serve up bacon and eggs and beans on toast on these very plates. So I am the very proud owner of these plates. So we always have dinner parties, special meals on the aerated bread company plates. Look and just be envious. This is the juice of the meat and the carrots and the bacon and the wine. Ah, right. So, carving the meat. Ooh. Oh my word. Oh, look at that. Fabulous. Ooh. Right, so. Oops. That is it for this day, the 16th of December 2017. The finished article.